Brain-computer interfaces are transforming the way human and machines interact. UTS is at the forefront of innovation in this area. In a project funded by the Defense Innovation Hub, Professor Francesca Iacopi and me are combining our expertise in developing wearable and wireless devices that measure brain waves and new nanomaterials to create a powerful brain-computer interface systems to control and operate vehicles, machines, and other devices.
A key component of our brain-computer interface system are the epitaxial graphene sensors, which are in contact with the scalp. Graphene is an atomic thin film, highly compatible with biological tissues, and is one of the most conductive materials. That makes it the perfect material for BCI sensors. We have overcome the limitations of existing brain sensors. They often wear out, corrode, or delaminate upon contact with the sweat, and are less effective in measuring brain signals. We have overcome those limitations by growing the graphene on a silicon carbide on silicon substrate. That combines the best of graphene with the best of silicon technology, creating a biosensor that is very resilient and robust to use. They are dry sensors that can be used and reused over prolonged periods and in harsh conditions. We can reliably collect the biopotentials from groups of neurons in the brain from outside the skull, hence in a non-invasive way, enhancing the potential for use in brain-machine interfaces.
Today, people interface with computers using keyboards, mouse, touch screens, etc. They could be replaced by interface directly from the brain. Our brain-computer interface system consists of miniature brainwave decoders paired with sensors. We use AI to reduce the noise that has affected brain-computer interface performance until now. We also use AI to decode the brain command from the brain signals when the human is performing normal activity with hands free. This has allowed us to issue multiple commands in seconds, which outperform the existing technology. Currently, people use touch to control computers, appliances, vehicles, and machinery. In the future, there will be sensors embedded in what people wear that can detect brain signals and can control things using thought.
Our collaborations has allowed Francesca and me to develop brain-computer interface technologies that has enormous potential in many applications in the industry, medical, and disability sectors.
Whether it is for operating a wheelchair, working on a computer without using hands, or directing machinery in an adverse or dangerous situation, there are many potential applications for our system.